When vacuum forming interim and test sockets, the ideal result depends on a whole series of factors. Let's go through them step by step. After the film is pulled off of it, the vacuum forming sheet is cleaned with isopropyl alcohol and then clamped into the vacuum forming frame. Then we hang it in the oven. The temperature recommendation should be noted here. It is based on the type of oven. We have an infrared oven here. The ideal temperature for ThermoLyn Clear is 165 degrees C. The oven time depends on the thickness of the sheet. A good rule is 1 minute in the oven per millimeter of thickness of the sheet. In our example, 12 millimeter thickness of the sheet means about 12 minutes of oven time. We can take advantage of this by using the time to prepare the plaster model for the vacuum forming process. My colleague soaks a residual limb sock in plaster parting agent and then pours it over the model. More plaster parting agent can be applied later if needed. Here is the location where we screw in the valve dummy. So we cut a hole in the residual limb sock and then screw the dummy in. Good thermal gloves are required, of course. A bit of feel for the process is required for the vacuum forming itself. Another good rule for the correct melting temperature of the sheet is the depth to which it sags should be about 2/3 of the height of the plaster mold it is pulled over. The center of the sheet should be placed on it. The next task is to manage two processes simultaneously, both the slow vacuum forming as well as the shaping, with the goals of achieving as uniform a wall thickness as possible and of avoiding wrinkles. Finally, the vacuum is activated. The formed socket must now cool. A common mistake is to accelerate this cooling process, for example with ice-cold air, or to try to save time by turning off the vacuum. Neither of these is recommended since they reduce the quality of the socket, so some patience is required. Once the material has cooled, the socket is cut out. But be careful, the material is heat sensitive and can be deformed during cutting if you remain at the same spot for too long. The socket is now removed from the plaster model. Neither the model nor the socket should be damaged in the process. After we have removed the screw from the dummy, we use a winch as an accessory. We come to the grinding. First the dummy is ground free on the surface grinder. The edge processing then follows. We first grind with a coarse drum, then with a fine sander, then with a polishing disc. To get the edges really smooth, we can use a silicon cone and a hot air gun. But please note that the heat can deform the material if it stays in one spot too long. What should be avoided at all costs is the use of thinners and solvents. They reduce the service life of the socket. Done. We proceed in a very similar way when creating definitive sockets, except that there are a few other things that have to be noted to get an optimal result. We'll show you what those are in episode 2.